DJI bench. Pegasus snooping charge is serious, but why no FIR until now? Hello and welcome to Inventiva. This is Palak Yadav presenting today's big news. Describing the allegations of surveillance through the use of the Pegasus spyware as serious, the Supreme Court on Thursday wondered why no one has filed an FIR if there was reason to believe that phones had been hacked. It also pointed out that the allegations first surfaced in 2019. Chief Justice of India, N.V. Ramana, who along with Justice Suryakant was hearing 8 petitions seeking an independent probe into the matter, said, "No doubt the allegations are serious, if the reports are true." The bench did not issue notice to the centre and instead asked the parties to first supply copies of their petitions to the Government Council, after which it would hear the matter again on August 10th. "Somebody should appear for the government to take notice," it said, making clear that the question of issuing notice will be considered after hearing from the government as well. The bench indicated that most of the petitions were based on news reports and should have had something more than the court to set the legal process in motion. As we all know that there is a prime facie material as well as credibility of reports on the basis of which we can order an inquiry, etc. Unfortunately, from what we have read in the writs, this matter came to light in May 2019. It is not known if any effort was made. Persons who have filed these writ petitions are knowledgeable people having resources. They should have made more efforts to bring forth more material. Some of the petitioners who have filed the pleas are not affected and some claim their phones are hacked. But they have not made efforts to file a criminal complaint, the CJI said. This led to exchanges in the courtroom with senior advocates representing the petitioners making their submissions on the pleas. Appearing for 2 journalists whose names figured in the alleged Pegasus target list, senior advocate Arvind Datar said that there is no provision in the IT Act 2000 for filing an FIR. The criminal remedy in the Act, Datar said, relates to infringement of privacy in relation to bodily parts, while the identity of the hacker needs to be known in civil remedy for damages. "Privacy is about the privacy of one's bodily area, so there is no provision for us to file an FIR. Someone has definitely accessed the computer, and remedy its damages. And for what we should know, who did it? We need to know if the allegations are true," he said. Referring to the Aadhaar judgment, Datar said that the Supreme Court had stated that privacy permits all through Part 3 of the Constitution. Urging the bench to take cognizance, he said, "Today 300 people have come to light. Who else will take cognizance of this apart from the judiciary? We don't know if it is 300 or 3,000 individuals. He said that this can be taken up as a class action case. Senior advocate Shyam Diwan, appearing for academician Jagdeep Chokar, said, "These media organizations enjoy a very high degree of credibility. A whistleblower released the numbers. These numbers are of judicial and constitutional authorities. Mr. Chokar is an academician, and for a private citizen to find a spyware installed on his phone is equal to war against a citizen by the government," he said. Asked if he had filed any FIR, Diwan said no, and this case requires an independent probe by a fact-finding committee under a bureaucrat of the highest level, preferably the cabinet secretary.